the first day of our retreat, where we targeted our heart. This way, we're also strengthening our heart. So I hope you're ready. What you're gonna need is, of course, your yoga mat. You might wanna have a glass of water, because we're gonna sweat a bit. Today, we're gonna start standing. So place your feet as wide as your hips. Really feel that your feet are firm into the mat. Then start to interlace your fingers under your chin. And then bring your elbows together as much as you can. We're gonna do a breathing exercise where we're really stretching our lung tissues. So on your inhale, you draw your belly in, you bring your elbows up. And on your exhale, you sigh up through the mouth, you bring your elbows together. On your inhale, bring your elbows up, suck your belly in. Exhale, sigh out through the mouth. Again, inhale, suck your belly in, bring your elbows up. Exhale, sigh out through the mouth. We're gonna do five more of these. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, exhale, inhale, last one, make it your fullest, and exhale, and release, keep your body a shake. Now start to close your eyes, start to bring your attention inwards. Start to deepen your breath. When you inhale, breathe from your belly, then your ribs, then your chest. And on your exhale, deflate the chest, the ribs, the belly. On your inhale, breathe from your belly, your ribs, your chest. Exhale, chest. Arms as well. So on your inhale from the belly, your ribs, your chest, bring the arms up. And on your exhale, bring the arms down, deflate the chest, the ribs, the belly. Inhale, arms up, belly, ribs, chest. Exhale, chest, ribs, belly. One more time. Inhale, belly. Ribs, chest. On your exhale, chest, ribs, belly. And come to the top of your mat if you're not already there. Again, feet are as wide as your hips. On your inhale, bring your arms up. Exhale, fall forward, hinge from your hips. Bend your knees here so belly is glued to your thighs. On your inhale, step your right leg back, big step. Exhale, lower your knee, untuck your toe. Then inhale, bring your arms up. On your exhale, grab with your right hand, your left wrist, and move to your right side. One more breath. Maybe feel that stretch on your left side of your body. Then inhale back. Start to walk your hands forward. Bring that left hand forward and up. Open up the chest. Exhale, left hand down. body. Whenever your body needs a rest, come back to child. Then inhale, come to table. Exhale, downward facing dog. 3 rounds of breath here. If you followed my other classes, you know that on every inhale you lengthen the spine, on every exhale you bring your heels towards the mat. On your next inhale, tuck your right foot in between your head, bring your chest forward, exhale, left foot meets right, forward fold. Inhale, come all the way up, bring your arms up, and exhale, arms down. Now do the other side, inhale, bring your arms up, exhale, fall forward, inhale, step your left leg back, big step. Exhale, lower your knee, untuck your toe. Inhale, bring your arms up. On your exhale, grab with your right hand your left wrist, move to your right side. Then inhale, back to center. On your exhale, grab with your left hand your right wrist, move to the left side. Inhale, back to center, baby back bend, activate the lower belly. On your exhale, hands down. On your inhale, walk your hands back, straight your front leg. Exhale, bring belly to thigh. On your inhale, walk your hands forward, bring your right hand forward and up, open up the chest. Forward. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, step or jump, chaturanga. Inhale, press up. Upper facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Three rounds of breath. Push all of your fingertips wide into the mat. Focus on that long spine. Don't worry about the hamstrings. On your next inhale, step or jump in between the hands, half lift. Exhale, fall forward. Inhale, come all the way up, bring your arms up. And exhale, arms down. Take a moment to observe the body. Feel if you have created some heat already. If you have your eyes closed, start to open them up. On your inhale, bring your arms up. Exhale, fall forward. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, step to your high plank. Stay there. So in this high plank, really press the ground away from you. You might want to place your feet a bit wider than your hips. Make it easier. Then on your inhale, lift your right hand up. Open up the chest. Exhale, bring your right hand under your left arm. Inhale, bring your right hand up again. Exhale, bring your hand under your left arm like you're having a ball of energy in your hand. Inhale, bring your right hand up. One more time. Exhale. Bring the right hand under your left. Inhale, bring your right hand up. Come into a side plank, like both feet on top of each other. On your inhale, you lengthen. Then on your exhale, come into your high plank again. Again, place your feet a bit wider than your hips. On your inhale, lift your left hand up. Exhale, bring the left hand under your right arm. Inhale, left hand up. Exhale, bring it under your right arm. One more time. Inhale, lift the left hand up. Exhale, bring the ball under the right arm. Inhale, lift the left hand up. Again, come into your side plank. Focus on a long spine, long arm. Stretch out long on your inhale. On your exhale, you're going to bring your left forearm on the mat. Then roll onto your left side, bring your right hand up. Again, we are in a side plank, but on our forearm. Then on your exhale, bring your right forearm parallel to the front of the mat, and roll onto your right side, bring your left arm up. One more time. On your exhale, place your left forearm to the front of the mat, roll onto your left side, bring your right arm up. Inhale, press up into a high plank. Exhale, down into a low plank. Inhale, up into a high plank. If you want to do this on your knees, please do so. On your exhale, come into a low plank. Inhale, press up, high plank. Exhale, lower down, low plank. Inhale, press up, high plank. Exhale, lower down, low plank. Inhale, press up, high plank. And exhale, come to your downward facing dog. If this is not a resting pose for you, bring your knees as wide as the mat, toes are together, lower the hips, come into your child's pose. Whenever your body tells you that it's enough, come back to your child's pose. On your next inhale, make your way to table. On your exhale, downward facing dog. On your next inhale, step or jump in between the hands, half lift. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, come all the way up, bring your arms up. And exhale, arms down. Inhale, bring your arms up again. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, half lift, crown away from the tailbone. Exhale, step into your high plank again. From here, we're going to do 20 mountain climbers. So you can either go with this pace, so knee to nose, back, knee to nose, back, or you can follow me by going faster. We're going to do 20, right and left. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, heels towards the mat. On your next inhale, bring your knees as wide as the mat. Toes together. Come into your child's pose. Again, try to slow down your breath. By deepening your breath, you slow down your heart rate. When your heart rate slows down, your mind will slow down too. This is also what happens when we are nervous. Our heart rate goes up. If we can control our breath, we can control our heart, we can control our state of mind. Inhale, make your way into table. Exhale, downward facing dog. On your next inhale, step or jump in between the hands, half lift. Exhale, fall forward. Inhale, come all the way up, bring your arms up. And exhale, arms down. Now start to bring your toes together, heels slightly apart. On your inhale, lower the hips, bring your arms up, Uttanasana. Exhale, fall forward, Uttanasana. Inhale, half lift, crown away from the tailbone. Exhale, step or jump into your chaturanga. You're going to do a lot of chaturanga, so feel free to skip it. Do your up dog, exhale, down dog. On your inhale, step your right foot in between your hands, bring your left heel down, bring your arms up, warrior one. Exhale, arms down, chaturanga. Inhale, press up, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. On your inhale, step your left foot in between your hands, lower your right heel down, bring your arms up. Exhale, arms down, chaturanga. Feel free to do an extra chaturanga if you want a bit more. So you can either skip it, go straight to your down dog, or add an extra one. your choice. Let's say 3 rounds of breath here. On your next inhale, separate jump in between the hands. Half lift. Exhale, fall forward. Inhale, come all the way up, bring your arms up. And exhale, arms down. Again, toes together, heels widely apart. On your inhale, lower the hips, bring your arms up, Uttanasana. Exhale, fall forward. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, step or jump, Chaturanga. Inhale, press up, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. On your next inhale, lift your right leg up. Exhale, step your right foot in between your hands. Stay in a high lunge. On your inhale, bring your arms up. On your exhale, place your hands onto your hips. We're gonna do some lunge jumps. So either do lunge jumps and follow me, or just step into your lunges. And when I stop, you stop. Okay, are you ready? You gotta do 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Woo. Inhale, bring your arms up. Exhale, Chaturanga. Feel free to add another one if you like. Inhale, press up. Upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, lift that left foot up. Exhale, step your left foot in between the hands. Inhale, bring your arms up. Exhale, hands onto your hips. Again, we're gonna do 10 lunge jumps or normal lunges. Your choice. Are you ready? Go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Inhale, bring your arms up. Exhale, Chaturanga. Inhale, press up, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. 3 rounds of breath here. Remember, you can always come back to child's pose. On your next inhale, step or jump in between the hands. Half lift. Exhale, fall forward. Inhale, lower the hips, bring your arms up. Uttanasana. Exhale, arms down. Let's take an extra couple of breaths. I still need it. So maybe close your eyes, tune inwards. Try to deepen your breath to slow down your heart rate. Again, bring toes together, heels slightly apart. On your inhale, lower the hips, bring your arms up, Uttanasana. Exhale, fall forward, Uttanasana. Inhale, half lift, drawn away from the tailbone. Exhale, step or jump, Chaturanga. Add an extra one if you like, or go straight to your downward facing dog. On your inhale, step your right foot in between your hands. Take an exhale here. Now on your exhale, we're going to make a big transition here. We've done it in our previous class a couple of times. On your next inhale, you shift your weight forward. You bring your left foot up into warrior three. And on your exhale, come back to Anjaneyasana and tap that left knee down. Inhale, shift your weight forward, warrior three. I need to make sure I don't fall in the pool. And exhale, come back, tap that left knee down. Inhale, shift your weight forward, warrior three. Exhale, come back, tap the left knee down. Inhale, shift your weight forward. Exhale, come back, tap your knee down. One more time. Inhale, shift that weight forward. Exhale, come back, tap your knee down. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, flow through your vinyasa. From a high plank, chaturanga. Inhale, press up, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, step that left foot in between your hands. Take an exhale here. Then inhale, bring your arms up. Same thing here. Five times, we're going to shift into warrior three. Inhale, shift that weight forward. Right leg up. Exhale, come back, tap that right knee down. Inhale, shift your weight forward, warrior three. Exhale, come back, tap your knee down. Inhale, shift your weight forward. Exhale, tap your knee down. Two more times. Inhale, shift your weight forward. Exhale, tap your knee down. One more time. Inhale, shift your weight forward, warrior three. Make it your strongest one. Exhale, come back, tap your knee down. Inhale, make yourself long. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Again, come back to your breath. Feel free to come into child's pose if this is not a resting pose. On your next inhale, step or jump in between the hands, half lift. Exhale, fall forward. Inhale, bring your arms up, lower the hips down for Utkatasana. Exhale, straight the legs, bring your arms down. Again, take a couple extra breaths. Apart. On your inhale, lower the hips, bring your arms up, Utkatasana. Exhale, fall forward, Uttanasana. Inhale, half lift, crown away from the tailbone. Exhale, step or jump, chaturanga. Feel free to add the extra one. Inhale, press up, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. On your next inhale, step your right foot in between your hands, stay here. Now we're gonna hop and switch our legs. So hop and switch. We're gonna do 10 of these. If you want, you can also step back into your high plank and then switch your legs without the jump. So choose whatever version that works for you. Are you ready? Go, we're gonna go for 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Inhale, bring your arms up. Exhale, arms down, chaturanga. Inhale, press up, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, heels towards your neck. On your inhale, put your left foot in between your hands. Stay here. You're gonna do the same thing. Pick your version. I'm gonna go for 10 again. Are you ready? Go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Inhale, bring your arms up. Exhale, arms down, chaturanga. Feel free to do the extra one. Inhale, press up, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Now bring your knees as wide as mat, lower the hips. Bring your arms forward into child's pose. Enjoy these moments of quietness. Start to wash your hands through the left side of the mat. Place your right hand on top of your left. Do the stretch in your right, on your right side.
still focus on deepening your breath. So walk your hands to the right side of the mat. Place your left hand on top of your right. Feel a stretch on the left side of your upper body. And on your inhale, come back to center. And exhale here. Then on your inhale, make your way to table. Exhale, downward facing dog. On your next inhale, step or jump in between the hands, half lift. Exhale, fall forward. On your inhale, lower the hips, bring your arms up, Utkatasana. Exhale, arms down, straight the legs, Tadasana. Again, focus on slow down your breath. Heart rate. Slow down the mind. Start to place your feet as wide as the hips. On your inhale, bring your arms up. Exhale, fall forward. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, step or jump, chaturanga. Then inhale, press up, upper facing dog. Exhale, downward facing. On your inhale, bring your right foot up. Exhale, step your right foot on the outside of your right hand. Take an inhale here. Exhale, walk your hands back, straight both legs. Inhale, walk your hands forward, bend both knees. Exhale, walk your hands back, straight both legs. Inhale, walk your hands forward, bend both knees. This time, lower that left knee down. Feel free if you have space here. If you have more space, you can bend your elbows, but you're not going to stay here too long. Then on your next inhale, press up. On your next exhale, place your left foot on the outside of your left hand. And lower the hips down. You are in a yogi squat. If this is not available for you, if you have a block or a pair of books, you can put it under your bottom. Stay a bit higher. Then on your inhale, come all the way up, bring your arms up. Now make sure your feet are as wide as your hips. Now on your exhale, sink into the hips, bring your arms forward. You're going to do 10 squats. Keep your arms forward, bring your weight in the heels. Then inhale, come up. Exhale, down. Inhale, come up. Exhale, down. Inhale up, exhale down three, inhale up, exhale down four, inhale up, exhale five, inhale up, exhale six, inhale up, exhale seven, inhale up, exhale eight, inhale up, exhale nine, inhale up, exhale 10. Inhale, come all the way up, bring your arms up, and exhale, arms down. Inhale, bring your arms up again. Exhale, fall forward. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, step or jump, chaturanga. Inhale, press up, upper facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. On your inhale, bring your left foot on the outside of your left hand. And exhale here. Then on your next inhale, walk your hands back, straight both legs. Exhale, walk your hands forward, bend both knees. Inhale, walk your hands back, straight both legs. Exhale, walk your hands forward, bend both knees. Inhale, walk your hands back, straight both legs. Exhale, walk your hands forward. Place your right foot on the outside of your right hand. Again, visual version. Stay a couple breaths. Then inhale, come all the way up. On your exhale, place your feet as wide as your hips. Place your hands on your hips. You're going to do 10 squat jumps. If this is too much for you, you can do the regular squats that you did before. Are you ready? Go. 1, 2, 3, 4,
6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Come all the way up. Bring your arms up. And exhale, arms down. Inhale, bring your arms up again. Exhale, fall forward, hinge from the hips. Inhale, half lift, crown away from the tailbone. And exhale, flow through your vinyasa. Or go straight through your downward facing dog. On your inhale, step your right foot in between the hands, lower your left heel down, bring your arms up for warrior one. Check your base. Are your hips facing forward? Then open up for warrior two. Check your base again. Front. Heel in the same line as your back arch. Every exhale, you sink deeper into the front leg. Then on your inhale, flip the front palm, bring it up and back, reverse your warrior. Don't bring too much weight in this back hand. Now on your next inhale, you come to center. On your exhale, we're gonna come into a, we're gonna come to the side. Like you are in an extended side angle, but you're not, you don't have any support. So inhale, come up, reverse warrior. Exhale, come up into your side angle without support. Inhale, come up, reverse warrior. Exhale, side angle. Inhale, come up, reverse warrior. Exhale, side angle. One more time, inhale. Reverse warrior. Exhale, step or jump, chaturanga. Inhale, press up, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. On your inhale, step your left foot in between your hands, lower your right heel down, bring your arms up, warrior one. Again, check your hips. On your inhale, step or jump in between your hands, half lift. Exhale, fall forward. Inhale, come all the way up, bring your arms up. And exhale, arms down. Now again, bring your toes together, heels slightly apart. On your inhale, lower the hips, bring your arms up, Utkatasana. Now on every exhale, we're gonna lower down. Take an inhale. Exhale, lower. Inhale. Exhale, lower. Inhale. Exhale, lower. Inhale. Exhale, lower. Inhale. Exhale, lower all the way to the mat. We're not resting yet. We're going to come immediately into Navasana boat pose. So sit onto your sit bones. Lift your feet up. You can grab your knees from behind. Really bring your chest forward. And if you're able to, bring your arms alongside your body. Three rounds of breath. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Lower your feet down. Lower your hands under your shoulders. Lift your hips up. Reverse cable. Exhale. Lower the hips down. Immediately come into Navasana boat pose. Three rounds of breath again. Again, sit onto your sit bones. Arms alongside your body if you can. Focus on a deep breath of observe if the deep breath makes it easier to stay in the pose. Then on your exhale, lower the feet down, lower your hands under your shoulders, lift the hips up, look up. Then exhale down, one more time, lift your feet up for Navasana boat pose. Then exhale, lower your feet, hands under the shoulders, lift the hips up, look up. And exhale down. Now we're gonna slow down. So bring the soles of your feet together, knees apart. Again, sit on your sit bones with a long spine. And on your exhale, come forward. Hold your feet like you're opening a book. Feel, observe your breath. Observe your heart rate. Make your way onto your back. Then bring that right knee towards your chest. Straighten your left leg. Flex that left foot to really activate that left leg. Then on every exhale, you bring that right knee closer towards your chest with your hands. On your next inhale, bring your right foot up in the air and grab your leg from behind, the back of your thigh. So you can either grab the back of your thigh, you might want to grab the back of your calf, you might want to grab your big toe. Pick your version. Feel that stretch on the back of the leg. Start to straighten your right leg forward. Engage that right leg. Then bring your left knee towards your chest. Bring your left foot up in the air, grab that left leg from behind, that can be the back of your thigh, can be the back of your calf, it can be grabbing your left big toe. Start to bend your left knee, still keep it. Left foot up in the air. Grab that left foot from the outside. Your elbows on the inside of your knee for half half day. And grab with your right hand the outside of your left knee. Release that left foot. And then bring your knee to the right. Your gaze to the left. bring the soles of your feet together, your knees wide apart. You can either have your hands alongside your body or on the inside of your hips. If it's too much, bring your feet a bit further away. Or support your knees with some cushions or blocks. Try to go for a belly breathing. A deep belly breathing. Your body, bring your feet up in the air. If you have a block with you, then place your block under your sacrum. It helps you to keep your feet up in the air. I usually do so, but I don't have a block right now. So if you have a block, you might have to search for that sweet spot, because it should not take any effort to keep your feet up in the air. Exhale, lower your feet down. Straighten your legs. Arms are alongside your body, hands come facing up. Inhale, you feel more energy. On every inhale, you feel more alive. Now on every exhale, you let go of something that doesn't serve you. Every exhale, you release the toxins. On every exhale, you sink deeper into your mat. On every exhale, you let go of any unnecessary tension. Thank you. control onto your right side. And when you're ready, press yourself up to a seated position. During the day, again, we're going to share recipes, tips of boosting our immunity.